Dig your way out of the hole. Digging your way out of the hole.
Grandma's porch. Sit down, relax, enjoy. Here on Grandma's porch.
Dig your way out of the hole. Dig your way out of the hole. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Brienne. Well, y'all know I don't give advice. I don't give suggestions. I just share with you how I live life and how I see life. And so I'm going to share with you my perspective on when you feel like you're in a hole and you can't get out. You know, I have been in a hole a few times in my life in situations, really, actually, they were not at my own fault, okay? And many times we create our own hole or we dig our own hole. And in these situations, they were kind of, these were early on in my life. I was kind of put in that hole, so to speak, in life. And I had to find a way to dig out. And I really didn't know if I could ever dig my way out, but I did. I did. And I'll give you an example. One of the holes that I felt that I was in an environment early on that it really wasn't an environment that you could grow in, that you could progress in, and build a great life in, as far as I was concerned. Now, I know some people have done that, and that's amazing and wonderful, but it would have been extremely challenging for me to be able to do that. And so early on, I began digging my way out of that particular hole and getting myself to where I needed to be in life so that I could grow and I could expand and I could be my best self. So yes, I've had a few holes in my life. Now, I'm not a person that digs their own hole for, you know, for the most part. I don't think I do. I think I'm a person that's always building. Some people dig their holes, some people build, and I'm a builder, creating wonderful, wonderful in my life. And yet sometimes we can get in a hole at no fault of our own, or even at a fault of our own, you know, a poor choice or whatever. So how do you get out of the hole? Well, I believe it's got to be done in the right way. You've got to make right decisions, right choices. You've got to choose to get out of that hole, and you've got to be willing to do the work no matter how long it takes, how much work it takes, and you've got to persevere. You got to keep on going even when you don't feel like it if you want to get out of that hole. And I know many people, you know, way back then that wanted to get out, but they weren't willing to do the work or they weren't willing to persevere. And then I knew others who were, and I was one of those people that were, and that did the work that made it happen no matter how hard it was. And it was hard at times, you know, when you're starting off and you're leaving one place and you're going to another. And I was so young. I mean, it was very challenging. I moved away to California at the time, and really I was so much on my own. It was, you know, I was very young. I was probably 19. And so what I'm saying is that everyone has to decide what is what they want and what's right for their life and what they're willing to give to make it happen. And so for me, I was willing to give a lot, and I persevered and I kept on to dig my way out of the hole. And so it could be a hole that you're stuck in a job that you don't like, you're stuck in a relationship, you know, and I'm not saying abandon the relationship. It may just take a lot of work to improve that relationship. That relationship probably just didn't go bad overnight. It probably was through a period of time, and sometimes we can restore a relationship. Sometimes we can't, but sometimes we can. So we have to decide, can we restore it? Not just do we want to restore it, but can we restore it? A lot of people don't want to restore it, and well, that's a decision that they're making. But if they choose to restore it, they've got to also know that it's restorable, and so that then they're willing to do the work and they're willing to put the effort. And many relationships are very, very restorable. Sometimes they take a lot of work, a lot of energy, and a lot of time, but that the results can be amazingly wonderful. Same way with a job. It doesn't mean we need to leave a job. Sometimes we can grow right where we're at, but we haven't done the work to make that happen. Other times we can't grow where we're at and we have to move on. So it's a personal decision what we're willing to sacrifice and what's really truly right for our lives. And then we've got to make new decisions. And sometimes it takes time to make those new decisions, or sometimes we try one thing and it doesn't work and we try another, or we have to fit the pieces together of the puzzle to make it work. But anyhow, digging our way out of the hole is often a process. Sometimes it can be a short process. Sometimes it can be an intermediate process. Sometimes it can be a long-term process. But the other alternative is to stay in the hole. And so I would prefer to dig my way out of a hole if I'm in a hole, persevering, making right decisions, realizing that it's going to take a lot of work, a lot of effort, a lot of right decisions. It may not happen overnight. It may take a period of time, or a long period of time for that matter, but often it's worth it. It's worth it. Could be bad health habits. A person's dug their hole so deep into bad health because of their bad health habits, but turning their life around in a positive direction is going to require discipline and making new decisions. So it could be a financial hole people are in. They've dug their way into a financial hole, so they're going to have to make new decisions to dig their way out of that hole. So, it could be any kind of hole that we've dug ourselves into. We can stay there, or we can begin digging out through the right decisions, choices, persevering, and the right energy. From my house to yours, may God bless you. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all of my channels. The links are pinned to the top of the comment section below. I have Grandma's porch covered up because of the heavy pollen. We are having such heavy green pollen here. So may God bless you from my beautiful day to yours. God, may God bless you, and I hope to talk to you soon again. Bye-bye.
To relax and a place to enjoy. Grandma's porch.